So in this small session of numerical methods, I like to do a numerical experiment with you, comparing some ways of doing a time discretization of a stochastic process. So we are still in this chapter that we have started in the last session, time discretization of stochastic processes. Here I gave you a little bit of intuition. So we've seen the Euler scheme. So just freeze the coefficients at the current time point and create the next time point by assuming the coefficient to be constant over that time step, which gives you an approximation. And you use this approximation also if you have to use the stochastic process as part of the coefficient. Then we looked at the Milstein scheme, which improves the scheme if the coefficient is not constant. So if it has a dependence on x, here only for the case that sigma depends on x, so sigma prime enters. And we also saw the predictor corrector scheme, which I won't use in this example. So I would like to compare these schemes in the time discretization of a log normal process. So a log normal process is, well, maybe an important example. Yeah, so the Black-Scholes model is an example. So it means that the coefficients, say in the Black-Scholes model, let's call mu r, are of the form r times s dt plus sigma, maybe let's call it sigma bar, yeah, because sigma on the previous slide was my function that was in front of the dw, and here the function is a sigma bar times s. In the previous motivation for the Milstein scheme, I call it sigma star. So the coefficient are proportional to s. Well, you can get rid of this if you move to the logarithm. So from Itô's lemma, you know that this means that d log of s, the logarithm of s, is also the stochastic process, and the coefficients in front of the dt and dw of this stochastic process look like r dt. So the s is removed, yeah, because if you differentiate with respect to the logarithm, you get a 1 divided by s. So if you differentiate the logarithm, you get a 1 divided by s. So this is r, and then from Itô's lemma, I get a minus 1/2 sigma bar squared. So I get this dt plus sigma bar dw. Okay, and I like to compare now different numerical schemes for such a stochastic process. I will consider the case r equals 0. Yeah, in a later numerical experiment, because that is already quite illustrative. And what we will do is actually we will do Euler scheme discretization of this stochastic process. You have a dependency on S. Maybe we can do Milstein scheme discretization of this stochastic process. And then the next trick is to do Euler scheme discretization of the log S, of the log process. And there is no dependency on S. I have constant coefficient. And then you see that actually Itô's lemma, so transforming the coordinate and then performing Euler scheme and then transforming the coordinate back, is a very powerful tool. Okay, so let's consider here a more general case. So I would like to consider here a log normal process. So a process that has here some sigma times x. So sigma now is a deterministic function. Yeah, it can still depend on time, but sigma does not depend on x. So there is a little bit ambiguity here on the slide. So my previous sigma that depended on t and x is now sigma of t multiplied with x of t. And I use, to save a little bit notation, the same symbol sigma, yeah? But actually it's a different function. Okay, so with Itô's lemma, I have that I can transform this 2d log has just a coefficient sigma dw, I will get an additional coefficient here, minus 1/2 sigma squared dt. Yeah? But the x is gone. So if I have Itô's lemma and I move to the logarithm of x, which is also a stochastic process, and I ask myself, what are the coefficients of this stochastic process in this short notation? Then I see that actually here this x is removed. This is a very classical stochastic process. As I already mentioned, the Black model, the Black-Scholes model are of this form, or in higher dimension, the Liber-Market model, the classical log-normal Liber-Market model are of this form. Yeah, so it's important, important class. First step, apply Euler scheme. So I apply Euler scheme. I have that the value at the next time discretization point is the value at the previous time discretization point, plus the coefficient frozen at the previous time discretization point. So that is here mu at ti, x tilde of ti, multiplied with x tilde of ti. So that is my coefficient evaluated at ti, x tilde of ti, times delta ti plus sigma ti, x tilde of ti. So there is immediately obvious here an issue. I have to write the initial value. The initial value is x tilde of t0 is just x0. Assume my initial value is a constant. My initial value is maybe this value. So my x0 is just this value here. Okay, so then you see that this coefficient here is also just a constant, right? Yeah, my initial value is a constant. Sigma is a deterministic function. This is just a constant. So it means I see that x of t1, which is the same as x tilde of t1, which is not the same as x tilde of t1. I'm doing an Euler step. So you see that x tilde of t1 is normal distributed. Yeah, because you see that here this guy is a normal distributed random variable and all the other guys are constant. Yeah, so it is a normal distributed random variable multiplied with a constant, and a constant is added, so that will change the variance and it will change the mean. Yeah, but the distribution is still normal distribution. So say here I have t1. So you have some normal distribution here. So I don't know where the mean is. I don't care. So maybe it looks like that. It's normal distributed. Okay. And you see a problem. It's possible that the value may become negative. It's possible that the value may become negative. But you know, from actually moving here to the logarithm, yeah, that you have that the logarithm is normal distributed. So if you move then back to the x, you have x is exponential of a normal distributed random variable. So x is an exponential of something. So x is positive. So we know that the exact solution of this Itô process is always positive. The Euler scheme approximation can become negative. Of course, we can reduce the risk that it becomes negative if we make the time step smaller, because the variance here is related to the size of the time step. And if I make the time step smaller, then the probability that it becomes negative becomes smaller. And then you see, if I slowly move here to zero, then the coefficient here in front becomes smaller. So it looks a little bit as making time steps smaller reduces the possibility that the Euler scheme approximation will become negative. But having a fixed large time step has this problem. So next discretization is Milstein scheme. And we know that Milstein scheme is just a correction of the Euler scheme. So here we have the Milstein scheme, and you know that the Milstein scheme is actually Euler plus 1/2 sigma times sigma prime times, and then there was a correction term, delta W squared minus delta T. Okay, so the minus delta T with this coefficient is this guy here. Huh? So because in our example, sigma times sigma prime is just sigma of T squared. Yeah. Okay, and the delta W squared part, okay, is this guy here. Sorry, of course, here times x of t. So you see that this is just the Euler step, x plus mu times x delta t plus sigma times x delta w. So this is just the Euler step plus these two corrections terms. And in my previous example, I had here the problem that if delta w is a large negative value, it can happen that the x tilde becomes negative. So think of doing Monte Carlo simulation. I generate here a random number. So if this random number is a large negative value, then I will have here a large negative value. So the good thing here for the Milstein scheme is that this will add a large positive value if delta W is large negative. Okay, so that is the Milstein scheme for the log normal process. Yeah, so we have a correction factor because sigma depends on x. And a last thing is, I would like to perform Euler discretization for the log process. So now I move here to the process logarithm of x, and I just do Euler scheme. And here Euler scheme is very nice. Yeah. Because the coefficient here in front is without an x. So of course, if sigma is a function, I still have here an approximation. Yeah. See, if sigma depends on t, I still have an approximation, but the error with respect to x is actually gone. And then I can apply the exponential on both sides, and I get this scheme. Yeah, the next value is the previous value multiplied with the exponential of this stuff here. Okay, so I call this log Euler scheme. And you have that the exponential here guarantees you that x of t I plus one is non-negative if I start from a non-negative value, yeah? So if x of ti, x tilde of ti is non-negative. Of course, in some cases where, for example, sigma does not depend on t, this is already the exact solution, yeah? Because sigma is a constant. And if you can integrate sigma explicitly, and also if you for example have that mu does not depend on x and you can integrate mu, then you can immediately write down the exact solution. So the exact discretization is my last thing here on the slide. It is like this log Euler scheme where I replace here the coefficients with the exact solutions of these integrals. Yeah? So this, of course, is possible if mu does not depend on x. Yeah? So the dependency on x on the sigma was already gone. Now, if I have in addition that mu does not depend on x, then I can do this and I can get the exact solution. So you see there is no tilde here. Yeah. Yeah. So This is not x tilde. It's not an approximation. It is the true solution of this stochastic process. Let me conclude with a numerical experiment. Just 1 minute. I have implemented three things. What I have done is I do now a numerical experiment of, say, the stochastic process dx equals sigma x dw. Sigma is a constant. And I do that with Euler scheme, Milstein scheme, log Euler scheme. So I also do it here with log Euler. And I check how good is the approximation of the mean and the variance of the logarithm of x of t, because the mean and the variance of the logarithm of x of t is known analytically. I do not go through the code, I just let it run. So you see I have here three different numerical schemes. Maybe just have a very short look. So this here is just Euler scheme. New value is previous value plus previous value multiplied with mu delta t. Previous value multiplied with the fusion, where the fusion is sigma delta w. So this here is really S times sigma delta w. Then I have a Milstein scheme. A Milstein scheme is just the same rule here, plus this Milstein's correction. So there is a Milstein's correction which adds a sigma squared delta w squared, okay? Delta w squared minus delta t, and here is 1/2 x sigma squared. And then I have the log Euler scheme, which does new value is previous value multiplied with exponential of this stuff, where you see the small correction here from Itô's lemma, minus 1/2 sigma squared. And you see that diffusion is now just sigma delta w. So there's no previous value here in front of that. Yeah, it's here. Yeah. Okay, and I let this run now with different time steps. Okay, so let this run with different time steps. So I have all these three schemes here, that guy, and that guy. So Euler, Milstein, and log Euler. And I compare it with the analytic value. So here there is the analytic value of the average and the variance. The analytic value of the average and the variance is known, yeah, because I know it is a log normal distribution. I can just look it up. What is the value that has to come out? And let's check how these three different schemes perform. Okay, so I use different time steps. So first I use only one time step. So I'm just jumping with the Euler scheme right to the end. Yeah. So I just have one time step. Yeah, jump with the Euler scheme right to the end. And you see that the mean and the variance are not a number. So why are they not a number? Because I have to calculate the mean and the variance of logarithm of S. And S is negative. So logarithm of a negative value is not a number. And that happens for also 11 time steps, 21 time steps, for many time steps. And then if the time steps are fine enough, there is no Monte Carlo path. So I use here 100,000 Monte Carlo paths. I have to check it, how many. There's no Monte Carlo path that becomes negative. And I have some kind of convergence. For the Milstein scheme, it may also happen that the value becomes negative. Yeah? But it is less likely because the approximation is much better. So even if I only use 11 time steps, it's already a non-negative value on all the Monte Carlo passes, on all the Monte Carlo samples. For the log Euler scheme, it works right out of the box. And if you use more and more time steps, the number of passes is here. Okay, it's 10,000 passes. If you use more and more time steps, you have some kind of convergence. And that's what we will do in the next session. Look at convergence. So if you like to have a few comments here in the script, here I have not a number. And also here I have not a number because logarithm is taken of s of t, and s of t may become negative, at least for these two numerical schemes. And these numerical schemes so have defects. You see that we have some convergence. So we have convergence. Well, the convergence looks a little bit. So how does it look? So if I have 400, so the mean error here is 1.3%. The variance error is 5. If I have 200, it's 8 and 2. So it looks a little bit as doubling the number of time steps is doing half to the error, say at least in the mean, also maybe half in the variance. It's 4.1 for 411. So it looks a little bit as if convergence is order 1 divided by n. Okay. And proving convergence and proving the order of convergence is what we will do in the next session. Thank you.